On today's episode of the DeRaud-Messinger Show, we're talking Texas basketball. Longhorns fans, don't forget to like and subscribe. We're getting closer to 1,000. We'd love to have you along the way. So Dylan, to begin, Longhorns are set to face Texas Tech in the opening round of the Big 12 tournament. Texas Tech is ranked number 20. What do you think of this matchup?
Well, Texas is currently projected in Joe Lenardi's bracketology to be the projected 3 seed in the tournament, while Texas Tech is projected 5 seed. And Devon, for Texas to get out of that 3 seed, they're going to need to win out of this tournament. That includes beating Tech, beating Kansas down the road, beating Oklahoma State with Cade Cunningham leading that drive, and then also Baylor at the end of the road, which they're just on a whole different tier that it's not even funny. So hopefully Texas can get some quality wins here, starting with Tech. This is going to be all on the guards this game. Obviously, Andrew Jones has been the leading scorer for Texas with 14.9 points per game. And with guards Courtney Ramey shooting 44.8% from the three-point line and Matt Coleman helping the cause, both averaging 33 minutes per game, the guards are going to be a big factor in this, especially against Texas Tech's guard in Mac McClung.
Yeah, you said Mac McClung, the Longhorn killer, apparently. Against Texas, he's just been on fire. And with Chris Beard at the helm, a Longhorns grad, they have beaten the Longhorns twice this year. And in one of the games, the first one, I believe, was a January matchup, they had that, not buzzer beater, I don't think it was, but right before the buzzer shot that ended it.
Yeah.
Not a pretty way to go. Hopefully that doesn't go that way in the tournament, but you never know. But after the Longhorns last lost to Tech, they've won 3 games in a row. Granted, one of them was to Iowa State, and Iowa State's not a great team this year, so a little bit of a cupcake if you want to use some football terms, but eh. And like you said, Lenardi has Texas as a 3 seed in the NCAA tournament. If they win a couple games, they might be able to sneak into a 2 seed, but that would be pretty difficult. Seems like they're more at risk at maybe falling to a 4 seed, but time will tell on that. But Dylan, did you know the last time Longhorns won a game in the NCAA tournament was 2014.
Yeah, and I mean, the closest memory I have, what, North Dakota State, buzzer beater, half court, I think that was the team, but it's just not great memories in recent events for UT fans. But hey, this team, after watching one of their games recently, the length just comes out of nowhere. These guys,
athleticism.
Exactly. They can, honestly, Texas got that feel is they can beat anybody, but they can lose to anybody. If they're going cold, there'll be a rough night. But if they're playing stellar defense, they can go up against anybody that they're playing. Especially with Texas Tech, if they keep Mac McClung at the 3-point line and don't let him inside, they have a really good chance of winning this game.
Exactly. If they get up, the key, as you're saying, is second half, they can't go cold. Half of Longhorns games, when they have the lead, they seem to choke away at least 10 points of that lead, and then it gets interesting. If they can beat Tech, they got to increment their way, and they could get that Big 12 championship finally in the tournament. Hey, 2019 NIT champions, but what do you guys think? How far the Longhorns are going to go in the Big 12 tourney? Let us know down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and have a great rest of your day.